Perry behind the net. Feeds it in front. Oh, Grant just had it roll off the end of his stick. Hellebuck gets the whistle, even though he didn't have the puck. And now Sherratt and Perry start flailing to the side of the net.
Well, what a pass from behind the net by Corey Perry.
And it's on now. This is a line brawl. In come Vatanen and Fowler. As gloves and sticks strewn all over the place, Sherratt just started throwing at Perry. And he is incensed.
Take a look. I mean, this is as dirty as it gets in hockey. You leave the butt end of the stick exposed, and he jams it right into the face of Corey Perry. That's a suspendable offense for Ben Sherratt. There's the damage that the butt end inflicts on Corey Perry.
He takes his shot, bounces to Lindholm. Perry scores! Corey Perry scores, and then Buffett hammered him from behind right after the puck went into the net.
The Ducks, who are settling into their game plan, have Maroon right in front where they like him. Corey Perry at the side of the net.
28-year-old Red O'Bara, who spent 8 years in the Swiss Elite League. And we got an injury, a big penalty coming up here. Is that Perry?
That's Corey Perry.
I thought so. Perry on his back to the play at the blue line as he dumped it in on the backhand. He got a run from behind, and he's in distress.
Here's a look at it. That could be a 5 minute for boarding penalty right there. That'll be interesting.
Well, it's a minor. I think he actually hit his head on the knee of the linesman who had jumped up on the boards there.
This game off the proper way because, man, you've earned this victory tonight. You've earned this complete. You should feel good about your effort. Now we got Marcian down away from the play. Might have been pressed.
So we get a look at it, Jack. Middle of your screen.
Oh, yeah. Well, hey, you know, I hope Brandon Prust has a nice suspension. That is intentional. That is cheap. That is outside the rules of the game. And that is delicious video for the boys in New York.
Best money I ever spent.
Whose sister Amanda scored the winning goal in the gold medal game for the World Championships for the United States over Canada last night.
Boy, high hit here by Anton Volchenkov. He leads with his elbow. I mean, this should be a 5 minute penalty. No intent at all to play the puck. He just led with his elbow.
Volchenkov's leaving. Brian Mock's taking him out.
And right there, is just that. That's a suspendable hit. There's no doubt about that. By Volchenkov.
Jimmy Hayes over the line to Marchand. Spooner in the gap. Back to Marchand. The shot off Kennan's leg. And it bounces back through the neutral zone. Marchand getting up, feeling a little bit dizzy. And remember, Marchand's already had one collision that resulted in a concussion this year when he rammed himself. And here's Marchand taking a pop at Landeskog, who was almost in a posture of saying, please sucker punch me so you'll get an extra two.
He goes right back to Marchand. And here comes the hit by Landeskog on the back check. Marchand went down briefly. See if we can take a look at where this principal point of contact is. Looks like it's shoulder on shoulder.
McAvoy twists the puck. Oh, Marchand takes a hit to the head from Provorov, and the Bruins are not too happy about that. We got a scuffle going on down by the pier. McDonald horse collaring Bergeron. Chara's in there looking for somebody's head to go bowling with.
And if you watch the hit by Provorov here, I mean, he's just doing his job. He thinks I can take the body in this situation.
He is a guy that's had a fine season. And it seemed under the former regime, if you will, that he was never really goodness.
Dustin Brown just KO'd Matt Cook.
And Matt Cook is a guy known for his hitting as well. Here's Brown leading with, he gets him with the shoulder. You can see the elbow's out.
Here comes Cook now. Vitali's having a hit in the head. Cherchik Cook right in the head. And Cook is dazed. Cook is dazed right now. Somebody else is dazed for the Penguins down.
And Hank Englund just jumped on Sarich.
And Matt Cook's going after somebody. And this was a headshot by Sarich right to the chin of Matt Cook. Matt Cook skating down the offside. There's that shoulder right to the head, and Cook is dazed.
You can see the elbow go out.
Just missed the goal. The key goes down in a heap. He's holding his face, gets back up.
And Cook's going to go after Keith here.
Or is that Keith? That was Cook that was down, right?
Yeah, it was Cook that was down, and he didn't see what hit him. I think it was Duncan Keith in the corner jumping in.
But it was Cook, and here it is.
Well, there's the hit right there. Cook hits Keith initially, and then, well, there's the shot, and it's under the head. It's to the head of Cook.
And now he takes a shot to the head himself, and he's going, wait a minute, I got suspended for that. He's
right to the head. That's a bad hit.
His third attempt was off a stick to Cook, and shovels that down to the side of the goal. And now Neal on Cook again. And now gives him a right hand to the face, and now Neal all over Matt Cook. A couple of rights, then a left, and neither player's gloves came off of that exchange.
Finally, as the puck gets into the mesh, Chris Neal takes a couple shots, right and left, and that's where we stand.
Avery, Nashville zone. His pass deflected right back to him. He gets hit hard, and Hordachuk goes after Avery, and Avery stays down on the ice, and now Hordachuk just wailing away. Not too smart on his behalf here with his team ahead 4-1.
And Avery just protecting himself on the play. Then back the other way, there's a hit. And watches Turcotte, instigation, punches. And Bob, at this point here, I think the NHL in this type of situation should consider, you saw Gleason come in and he wipes out the linesman.
Back come the Vegas Golden Knights. They haven't had quite the response tonight after being scored upon. Instead, this response is a physical nature.
You wonder, is Reeves getting a penalty here? He was, oh man, he cross-checked right to the face. Wilson in game one. This was kind of a nothing play. There was one cross-check, he got them both up. Wilson was going at him, but the glove got up first by Reeves.
Chimera streaks down the left side into the middle. Wilson got hammered as he hammered the shot into the corner. Wilson's hurt. Niskanen fired a shot as the whistle went.
Game on, isn't it?
Oh, is it ever.
It has really ramped up in this third period. So almost a slingshot right into him. And oh boy, that was on the button. That's a tough one there, as you know, was that the principal point of contact. But when you say, Glenn, because he was turning around, it's a hard one to drop
there. Threw one, and that went off the stick of Stamkos and wide. A healthy hit on Wilson, who goes down. There'll be a penalty coming up on this, and Wilson is shaken up.
Hopefully Tom Wilson is okay. And that's one of those there where you got to play the puck or, you know, kind of take a different angle to get shoulder on shoulder. And a boarding call.
There's a couple of helpers. 11:42, the time of Ovechkin's 20th on the season.
Ooh.
Wilson got hit again.
Yep. And I think it was Reeves that got him, wasn't it? And he's down. Watch Wilson come into the play, and that's a blindside hit. Puck's not around Tom Wilson. Here it is. He lets it go.
Vegas,
and that's a
five
hard hit major. That throws the helmet right off his head.
Leaves cover. They don't get it out right away. Shot away high. Play stopped. It went over the boards after the defense. As Bodywork picks up a bit here. Domi's on the receiving end again.
But here's the play. Domi chips it out. That's not the argument. Maybe the high stick at the end of it is.
Puck in for Michael. Domi comes up with a hit. Domi has hit himself. And there's going to be another penalty on that hit by Pearson, who's playing in his first game.
On the Ottawa defense. And Domi's cut, as you can see, as he went head first into the glass, is fighting off Jody Hall. And then from behind, you can see 5 minutes and a game misconduct. The center, that got the cheer, and Nichols flattens Ty Domi. Domi was shooting the puck in and then turned right into Bernie. And a good, solid, clean, middle of the ice check.
Left bomb. Against Lindholm, in deep, Zach Cassian gets bumped hard by you-know-who, Tkachuk. And Cassian's mad, and here we go, now there's going to be penalties in the game. They've been going at each other on and off all night, and Zach Cassian is incensed.
Now,
We showed earlier in the first period the one hit that knocked his helmet off, and here's the play. I don't know, you can't see. He's coming down.
No,
Cassian. No, and Cassian has the puck, so it's not like it's an interference call either. It's one of those hard hits.
He was coming down pretty fast, but he turned before the hit.
And right on cue, as we talked about the battle of Alberta, and here these two go at it hard, and Cassian's just throwing all of them.
Bennett trying to jump on that puck. Off the draw, we're going to have...
Penalty coming up.
Tkachuk has lost his helmet, and now Cassian started swinging. Tkachuk was not ready to go, or it appeared as though he wasn't. He turned away for just a second, Louis.
Old time, and right there, the shot by Cassian, and the shot to the head takes the helmet off, and they keep going at it. And then eventually Cassian just thinks maybe they're going to go, but no go as they just start to go at it.
Of elbowing, tripping, slashing, it's Al Secord of the Chicago Blackhawks and Dino Cicerelli of Minnesota. Take that.
Al Secord and Cicerelli exchanging physical fires.
With the game out of reach, Bolarice and Ryan Kessler continued a feud that had been ongoing for much of the game. Then Bolarice crossed the line.
You're looking at some serious suspension there.
You know what, I didn't see him coming.
Jesse Bolarice blindsided Ryan Kessler with a vicious cross-check that he immediately regretted.
I wanted to give him a hit back, and I reacted in a bad way.
Bolarice received a match penalty and an indefinite suspension and is awaiting further disciplinary action.
The incident occurred early in the second period of Wednesday's game between the Canucks and Ducks. Pronger and Kessler get tied up behind the net. Now Kessler falls down. Then Pronger appears to stomp on Kessler's left calf with his skate. Kessler was not injured on the play, but this incident draws some similarities to the stomp that earned Chris Simon a 30-game suspension earlier this season.